I had midterms just like a couple weeks ago, and I was studying economics, and I had to write a pantoum, so I decided to mix the two together.
Okay.
It's called An Ex-Friendship in Economic Terms. Your outputs are disproportional to my inputs. The slope of this curve has steadily decreased. Perhaps my demand for consistency is too great, but your supply has decreased to non-existent. The slope of this curve has steadily decreased. I have clung for months to the few words you spare, but your supply has decreased to non-existent, and one steady conversation a month doesn't equal a friendship. I have clung for months to the words, the few words you spare, but your pursuit of self-interest has led to negative outcomes, and one steady conversation a month doesn't equal a friendship. Hypothetically, utility can never be negative, but your pursuit of self-interest has led to negative outcomes. Preoccupations of the mind do not complement productivity. Hypothetically, utility can never be negative. However, the model is too simplified. Preoccupations of the mind do not complement productivity. I was willing to forget the cost of this opportunity. However, the model is too simplified in the measuring of the complexities of our externalities. I was willing to forget the cost of this opportunity, but your supply has decreased to non-existent. In the measuring of the complexities of our externalities, your outputs are disproportional to my inputs. And the next one is all in Spanish. Otra lugar, otro mundo. Cuando me llamas, no puedo oírte. Cuando te llamo, estás en otro lugar. Cuando nos vemos, vemos nadie. Estamos ninguno en este otro mundo. No es mío, no es tuyo. Es un mundo de miedo. And the last one is called Woman. There is something sacred and secret and mysterious about being a woman. There is a secret clinging pain when we say goodbye to our mothers or disappoint our fathers or disappoint our lovers or disappoint ourselves because we are women. There is something primal and needy in loving a man and something ancient and enveloping in loving a woman. And because I am a woman, I know this, I understand. I know nothing and everything. The innate knowledge of being me and of being a part of everything. Knowledge of being me and of being a woman. I know not enough and too much to hold inside myself, to imprison until death parts me from the living. I have tried being neutral, and I've tried being a man about things, and I have been censored regardless, so I've burned that match. Though, I have many more in my treasure chest, and more that I can buy or steal. My face varies with the occasion, trying to be everything my friends want, my teachers want, the world wants, and rarely showing who I truly am. I am a woman, but I'm also a phoenix, a creature of fiery hair and Buddhist instincts, a woman who has risen from ashes of arson time and time again, risen with a new name and a new face, lifted into the air through the struggling of her own two wings. First flights bear remembrance and grimaces. Many of my attempts at aviation have been bungled, ruined by oversteps, oversights, overthoughts. But those few times I have jumped and glided towards my future have been utter bliss. Because I am a woman, I am also a daughter. Joyfully a sister, and I know what it's like to have little siblings that waddle behind me like ducklings. Little mimics who grab the back pocket of my jeans and chuckle when I scold. And because I am a woman, perhaps someday I'll know what it's like to be a mother. To hold a small bundle of fragile life close and worry about a future that is not mine. Because I am a woman, I weep for the world's iniquities. And because I am a woman, I try not to weep for myself and not because I am a woman, but because I am me. I force myself to smear heart-drenched words across digital pages until somewhere among the screams and the whines, I hear truth whimpering. And I lift her from the wreckage and embrace her. Because I am a woman, I can write this poem, and because I am a woman, I need to say this. Neither the stigmas nor the joyful secrecies of women are all that I am. I am writer, singer, dancer, breather, reader, teacher, preacher, leader, guider, walker, watcher, healer. I am pathfinder, poet, painter, counselor, composer, creator, ally, friend, sister, daughter, both hopeful and anxious, because these choices of mine affect an unknown future. Because I'm not just any woman, and not just a woman.